And today I'm going to share with you my favorite collection ever, my Avatar The Last Airbender collection. I am literally so obsessed with Avatar The Last Airbender, so much so that I can't even watch it without crying because I just love it so much. It's that intense. It is a problem, but that just goes to show you that my love for this show is on a whole other level. And that is why I am in my firebending outfit today, which you cannot see, but I will insert a clip because I love this outfit, and this is definitely something that I would wear if I lived in the world of Avatar. But onto what this video is about. So as you can imagine, since Avatar The Last Airbender has come to Netflix and people have either rewatched it and reignited their admiration for the show, or people have watched it for the first time and realized how amazing it is, I've been seeing a lot of new fan art and edits of the show all over the internet. And it has gotten me pretty emotional, as you can imagine. But ultimately, I'm glad that it's trending again because one, it's amazing, and two, if something is popular, more merch is made for it. And boy, did I add some really cool things to my collection, so let's get into it. First thing I want to share is my pride and joy. I get a lot of comments from my videos on it, and it is my dear Appa poster. I look at it every day and just smile, and I think I bought this poster during my first trip to WonderCon, and it was my first piece of artwork that I ever bought. Then I found this perfect light wooden frame for it at the thrift store the next day and put it up on my wall. I seriously love it so much and actually want to buy another one to put in a different room, but I can't seem to find the exact same print anywhere online. So if you know where I can get one, please let me know. And off of that poster, if you were to ask me what my favorite animal is, could you guess? That's right, my favorite animal is a flying bison. I got this flying bison onesie for my birthday a long time ago, and it's the best onesie in the entire world. It even has a tail, guys, a tail! And I match with my Appa plushies. Okay, so my first flying bison plushie was this huge one, and I was ecstatic to get it. I didn't even know that they had sold these anymore, but Michael is my biggest supporter in my Avatar Last Airbender obsession and is somehow always able to find things that I didn't even know existed, like this onesie. Like, who would have known that an Appa onesie even existed? And like, where do you even buy this? So after having this for a year or so, he also gifted me this smaller Appa plushie, and they're both super duper cute. Now, some flying bison figures that I got recently were these pop figures. Like the plushies, I have a jumbo size and a regular size. I got these from Box Lunch during Christmas time, and they are both fantastic. The jumbo size Appa Pop is like fuzzy. I don't know what kind of material it is, but it's soft and it's really cool. And the smaller one is made of the same material that every other pop is made of, but it's super cute because it has a little tongue sticking out and it's just so adorable. Look at his face! Oh, but that's not all. I couldn't pass up the chance to also get this mini Appa Pop. It's actually a keychain, but I just keep it with the other figures because I know that I'll break it or it'll get messed up if I use it as an actual keychain. So it's nice and safe on my desk, making me smile every day. Alrighty, moving on to the smaller items. Whew, I actually didn't realize how big my Avatar The Last Airbender collection is until right now. So I'm actually going to speed through it. So I have a bunch of accessories and I got these either online or at WonderCon. Starting with these wooden pendant necklaces. I actually have a number of them, but my favorite one is this white lotus necklace. But I also really love my Fire Nation necklace because I see it as my betrothal necklace from Prince Zuko. But I also have these necklaces with the other nation symbols as well. They're all really awesome and honestly probably my favorite necklaces, even though I can't really match them with everything I wear. But just sentimentally, I love these necklaces. Next up, I have these Rava and Vatu patches. And okay, wow, when I came across these, I was like, yes, please, I need them. My original plan was to sew them onto an Avatar Last Airbender gem jacket, but I just never got around to making that. But I will though. someday. But yeah, these patches are so beautiful and well made. I love them so much, and I went ahead and bought a second pair. And I'm so glad I did too, because I recently went on to the same website that I bought them from and they're gone. Actually, that shop is gone, so I'm glad that I got multiple. Now, I've actually been meaning to buy more patches for my Avatar: The Last Airbender denim jacket, but since I haven't been actually like actively working towards making that, I haven't bought any more. But aside from the Rava and Vatu patches, I also have this Fire Nation patch, which is of course super cute, but I definitely need to buy patches for the other three nations so it could all be cohesive on the denim jacket. Alrighty, moving on to pins. The first pin I'm going to share with you is of my darling Prince Zuko. I have this pin of his adorable face, as well as a couple of Blue Spirit pins. The Etsy shop I got the original Blue Spirit pin from updated their design to this larger, glossier version, and it turned out so pretty that I had to get it too, even though I already had this one. But again, I'm obsessed, guys. I'm not kidding. Similarly, they had this original design for their Appa pins, and then they went ahead and updated it, and I had to get those too. But honestly, I don't mind it at all. The more flying bison, the better. And from a different shop, I also bought this tiny flying bison pin because I thought it was just really cute and really simple. However, I did also end up buying a really extra pin along with my really simple pin, and actually, I bought two really extra pins that were pretty expensive, but definitely worth it because they're awesome. The first one is this black and gold Aang Appa Four Elements White Lotus pin. It actually has a lot going on, but it looks epic. And the second pin is the same exact design, but you can see it more clearly because it's made of a different material. And you may be asking, well, what kind of material is it made of? My friends, this is made of glow-in-the-dark material. This pin is so flipping cool. I think it's awesome without it glowing, and then even like 10 times more awesome because it glows. It's just an overall incredible pin, and I want to collect more glow-in-the-dark pins, please. They're just like so hard to find. Alrighty, moving on to apparel, or should I say apparel? Roll a pair. Okay, never mind. Moving on to clothes. First up are these Appa socks that I got a few months ago from Box Lunch. They are dark blue with flying bison all around it. And the same day, I also picked up these Four Nation socks. They're just gray with the various nation symbols scattered throughout. Again, also from Box Lunch. Okay. So I kind of went crazy at Box Lunch when they came out with their Avatar Last Airbender collection. I practically cleared them out. I mean, I didn't get everything that they came out with, but these next 9 things are from Box Lunch, and that's not even the last of it. But again, everything that I'm going to talk about right now, from Box Lunch. I bought this gray, white, and blue Air Nomads t-shirt to represent the Airbenders. I bought this blue and white Water Tribe t-shirt to represent the Waterbenders. I bought this green and gold Earth Kingdom shirt to represent the Earthbenders. And I bought this red and gold Fire Nation t-shirt to, of course, represent the Firebenders. Oh, but wait, there's more. I also bought this blue Water Tribe Spirit Jersey style long sleeve shirt, as well as this tan Air Nomad jersey style shirt, which I honestly was a little disappointed that they didn't design it with blue arrows going down the sleeves, but I still really like it. I also bought this green Earth Kingdom Spirit jersey, and finally, this red Fire Nation Spirit jersey. Again, all from Box Lunch. Don't judge, but who am I kidding at this point? You already know I'm crazy, so let's just keep on going. I mean, while I was buying all these t-shirts, I was like, you know what? I might as well just clear out my bank account while I'm here, so let's get on with it. So in addition to all those shirts, I also bought this Avatar Last Airbender sweatshirt, and it has this really cute design that has these little chibi versions of all the characters. It's really soft, and I love it. And again, that is the last top from Box Lunch, but not the last thing from Box Lunch, but we'll revisit that later. Because I actually own some more Avatar The Last Airbender tops, but they're just not from Box Lunch. They're from other places like Hot Topic and Redbubble. I got this white top and it has Aang on it, and normally I'm a huge Zuko stan, but I thought that this Aang shirt was really cool. I really like the colors, and you know what? Aang is a really cool character. So again, that one was from Hot Topic, I think. And then this one is from Redbubble. Now this one is more accurate to who I love, and it is a Zuko t-shirt because, again, I love him so much. What does it say? Oh, it actually says Zuko's girl. And funny enough, Michael actually gifted this to me because he knows that I love Zuko and he is my 2D fictional character crush. And Michael is my 3D human real life crush. So I think he just likes to mess with me. But yes, I love Zuko very much. And the last t-shirt is from Redbubble and it is of a flying bison because he knows how much I love my dear flying bison as well. I love it. Alrighty, we're approaching the end here. I know, so sad. My voice is already dying because I've just been like yelling this entire video because I'm so excited to talk about my Avatar The Last Airbender collection. But trust me, these last ones are really awesome. In addition to my Pride and Joy Ava poster, I also have some other artwork. I bought this at WonderCon as well. It was so hard to find Avatar artwork at WonderCon, but I'm really hoping that there's a lot more Avatar The Last Airbender artwork at WonderCon next year, since there's been kind of like this revival of it. So hopefully a lot more artists want to make more ATLA fan art. And if so, I'm gonna be really happy, but I need to save up. I also have this mini artwork of my dearest Prince Zuko that I really need to find a frame for because I will accidentally mess this up somehow. So I need to keep it safe. Alrighty, last couple of things, all from Box Lunch. Again, I practically cleared them out. This ABBA pin that I totally forgot to mention earlier when I was talking about pins, but it's really cute. He has these little pink blush cheeks and it's just, they're so adorable. I also got this Flying Bison fanny pack. I love it for oh so many reasons. One, it's Avatar related, so of course I'm going to love it just right off the bat. Two, it has my favorite animal on it, flying bison. Three, its design is blue with white clouds, my favorite aesthetic. If you follow me on Instagram or have seen my headers for like all my social media accounts, I love the sight of white clouds against a blue sky. It's just so beautiful and so peaceful and so relaxing. I love it, and I love this bag. Okay, last item before I lose my voice. Best for last, I am obsessed. Like I mentioned earlier, Michael has this talent for finding things that either I didn't even know existed or is practically impossible to get. When I first saw a photo of this item online, I lost sleep over how much I wanted this. However, I could not find it anywhere. And it was not for lack of trying. For months, months, I searched for this thing. I reached out to so many people. I even emailed and DM'd the distributor of this thing. But they said that it was not for sale and they did not plan on putting it up for sale ever. And I was like, but why? It's so perfect. But after so many rejects and so many failed searches, I like died inside a little bit, but I just moved on and I was like, okay, I guess, you know, it's just not going to exist out in the world. I don't even know why that picture exists, just to make me sad that I can't have it, I guess. But Christmas rolls around and I'm opening up my presents and guess what's inside? The thing. What is the thing? This thing. An ABBA mini backpack. I need a moment. I love it so much. Okay, I love mini backpacks just in general. I got my very first mini backpack before it was like super popular and like a thing back in like 2015 for Christmas from Michael. He's just a great gift giver. But now I probably have like 30. And I mean, okay, I'm not made of money. A lot of the backpacks that I have were gifted to me either like as presents for Christmas and my birthday and stuff, or the actual like company sent them to me. But I mean, I do love them. But my point is, out of all of the bags that I own, I could wholeheartedly say that this Alpha backpack is my favorite of all time. Like, no comparison. I honestly don't even think that any other design could top this. Unless it's like another design of an Alpha backpack that's just better somehow. I don't even know how, but I love it so much. I am so happy that I was able to add it to my Avatar collection. Because even though, I mean, I know that my Avatar collection is just going to be ever-growing whenever I find something new Avatar-related that I like, I'm gonna buy it. It doesn't matter how huge my collection is, I'm gonna continue building it. If I can't live in the world of Avatar, I'm going to make sure that I have as much Avatar in my life as possible. But somehow, knowing that I own this Alpha bag makes my collection feel complete. But yeah, that was my Avatar The Last Airbender collection, and a little insight to how crazy I am. And yes, I do love other animes, and Disney, and Harry Potter, and Star Wars, and Lord of the Rings, but man, do I love Avatar. But anyway, that's enough. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. Please give a big thumbs up before you go. And let me know which item in my collection was your favorite, or what nation in the Avatar world would you like to live in? Would you like to live in the Fire Nation or the Earth Kingdom or any of the other ones? You already know that I would live in the Fire Nation with my husband Prince Zuko and be wearing this. Thank you so much again for watching. Don't forget to click the red subscribe button if you have not already, so I can see you next time. Bye, and have a magical day.